Well, greetings everybody, this is RAS2484, and welcome to the season finale of season 4 of ETS2. So, today, we're currently en route to pick up our final cargo for the season, and it's going to be some goat cheese. Don't know why it's goat cheese, but actually we're going to be taking it to a new part of France. We've not been to just yet, so we're currently in transit to go get it right now. So I'm filming this kind of late at night, so I was gonna get to it earlier, but okay. Okay, nobody laugh at me, all right? I forgot it was England. Oh, late night shenanigans. Gotta love it, right? I'm surprised I can get a traffic citation for that. That's a bit funny. Oh, that's interesting. There's a traffic light way the hell over there. I never noticed that. I wonder if they added it because a lot of people are complaining about that. You cannot see the thing there. Oh. Yeah. I thought that was quite funny. But so this is going to be an end of a season. I know this season's been fairly short, but of course with my rampant hiatuses that have been going on lately, it's not really been getting anywhere, so. Alright. Dad is past it. No. I am such a terrible driver in the UK. Alright. Let's go get it. This screen is so quiet. Okay, so here we have 34,000 pounds of goat cheese. Now the question is, has anybody ever had goat cheese before? I don't think I've ever had goat cheese. Some people will say it's a selective taste, you know. There's certain cheeses that are good, but goat cheese, even though it's fairly similar to regular cheese that we know of, I just never really tried it before. So anyway, it's going to Folkestone to Toulouse, France, which is actually more on the southern side of France. So it's more the southern portion of the Vive la France DLC that we're going to be checking out today. So with that further ado, let's go ahead and hook her up and let's get out of here. So we got things to do and cheese to deliver. Yeah. You know, I think it's best if I just... Okay. I find it a lot easier just to back in that way, because that's really what truckers mostly do, is they use that. Okay. So, first thing, order of business here is get out of England without being hit. Okay, you're not. Delivery truck, get out of the way. Get out of the way! Get. Good gravy, you already producing bad luck for me here. There we go. So, yeah. So I really wasn't really intending for this season to be so short, but you know how life happens and, well, you know, you do what you have to do. Whoa, dude. Okay. I was going a tad bit slow for you. Excuse me. So glad we're going to be out of the United Kingdom. I hate driving here. I mean, I got nothing against the country itself, but this is just unnatural. There we go. Just put her into cruise control because it's hard for me to do that. This is slow. So yeah, this is going to be quite a bit of a longer trip. I mean, it's going to be roughly about 700 and, speed limit increased. Get this thing on the road, shall we? What was I starting to say? There we go. Thank God for cruise control. I completely forgot what I was going to say. It'll come to me eventually. That's what I get for filming in late night. Oh, I forgot it's 60. Oh, yeah, I completely forgot about that. Yeah, because they redid some of the speed limits here in the United Kingdom, because, you know, usually it was only about 56 miles an hour. But I see they increased it to 60, so. That is good. Now, don't forget that we have different modes of travel. As far as the engine, I don't know what you call them, but they're different modes you can put it in. Like you can do normal, power, and economy. So, I've not forgotten about those, but. I hate these intersections like that. Always catch me off guard. So. Yeah, that's why I'm gonna stick to this lane. I hate that. Yeah. So, I mean, I've not forgotten about that. I just have, I've just recently got back into filming videos, because my on my many random hiatuses that I do. Yeah, it's, you know, it's pretty much the content I make is mainly just this game and ATS. So, I mean, I kind of try to spread out my content as much as possible, you know. So I don't really necessarily feel like playing any other game on YouTube, you know. I made a lot of attempts, but they all turn out to be failures, or they're just not the best quality, you know. So, is it back to 60? Okay. So I'm just going to be staying in the left lane until it's absolutely necessary for me to get over, because I just hate those intersections. You know, I really wish they did redo some of the road work here in England. You know, I just, you know, I mean, parts of it is okay, but some of those transitions when you're going over overpasses like that, when you're, you know, when there's an exit there for a certain road, and then there's, why is there always a car there? Get out of the way, dude. Get. All right. That crisis is averted. So every time I want to make a turn like that, an AI car always wants to get in my way. So we're nearing the docks here, so we're not too far from it. And then we're going to have our long journey across the northern and middle parts of France before we get to... Toulouse, or I've already forgotten the name. Oh, here we go again. I'm gonna go ahead and get over now, because I'm probably gonna. Okay, that was smoother. There's not much traffic right now on the road. It's only 4:20 in the morning, so. You know, realistically, I have to stop every 14 hours or so, but. Like I said, this is a simulator, you know, so we don't necessarily have to do that if we don't want to. Nice and smooth. Yeah, I like it. This particular stretch of road, I will stick to the left side, so I don't think we really have to worry about overpasses or nothing. So I think this starts merging into smaller. At least I think so. Yeah. Ooh. That's a nice bridge. Trado. Huh. So yeah, this is what I thought. Yeah, so my plans for the next season are going to be fairly simple. Is we're going to be finishing out the Vive la France DLC, finally, alright? And we're also going to be looking at the Heavy Cargo Pack DLC that just recently came out. It's going to have several heavy cargoes. Now, I don't know if this truck is actually really fully fitted out to do that, but... And the heavy Heavy Cargo's DLC pack DLC is it's a paid DLC, so I think it's only like $6 or something like that. It's really not much. So I do plan on purchasing that on Thursday, and we're going to be that's where we're going to start off season 5. So once we get done with the Vive la France DLC, I think that's going to be it for a while. Unless we got some, cities that we've not yet discovered yet in the main game. So, I might do that all in season 5. I really don't know. It just really just kind of depends on what gets done as far as, because we might have to go to other cities to, you know, to, for Vive la France, we might have to go to out of France and then back into France, you know, so on and so forth, so. Okay, so it's 50 miles an hour through here, so these small little country roads, and tend towards the docks once again. So, don't have much further to go. Yeah, so a small portion of it will be here in the United Kingdom, but once we get over to the France side, we will get back to driving on the right side of the road. So like as I was saying before, Season 5 is going to be mostly... let's see, we're going to be turning left, right here. Yes. I never get used to it. Alright, so it's a good, okay, here we go, here's a good spot here. So yeah, so season 5 is mainly going to be finishing up the Vive la France DLC, and look at the Heavy Cargo pack DLC for ETS2. Also, let's see. So, once we get done with all that, I hope you're going to let me in, yeah. Luckily, the AI is smart enough to know when the, you know, when it merges into smaller lanes to just to back the hell off, you know? So... I'm gonna slow the hell down. Okay, it looks like we'll be using the tunnel here, so that's a lot easier to use. So you can go in either two of them. It doesn't really matter. I like to go in the first one here just to Frankenstein of Calais. So it's only about. It's really not bad at all. Yeah, going to Toulouse. Yeah, there we go. I actually had to look at it to see what it is. It's Toulouse, France. Okay, I don't know what. That's weird. Seemed like it put me a little bit closer than what I was supposed to. That's odd. Alright, let's get the hell out of here. Let's, we got, yeah, we gotta get on the road here. So, should get there by somewhere by tonight. I always thought that it was so weird that all days are just all just deserted. You know, the realism as it is, there's gonna be a line of trucks leaving that train if they were you know, so. So yeah, once I quit interrupting myself, I'm going to talk about future plans for ATS-2. And ATS will return eventually, but yeah, I'll talk about that with you guys in just a few minutes. Okay. Was that driving on the left side? Wow. Seriously, I hate driving on the left side. Good grief. All right, folks. I'm okay. Wow. I'm just not. No, why? I'm just not. That's not. Just. Not. Throwing red flags on my brain here, so that's weird. All right, ooh, a little too relaxed there, Raz. All right, oh, excuse me. How about you yield? Hey, yeah, go on and get your ass out of here. Like, yeah, you think I was gonna stop for you? I don't think so. All right, so so yeah, we got a good 550 miles to go here. So luckily, we gassed up in Great Britain before we left. Set it on cruise control, and here we come, buddy. So, yeah, so, we are going up to the toll booth here. So, as we're going into the toll booth here, I will explain to you, without interrupting myself, exactly what's going to go down as far as, is this going to be one of those? No, it's not. No, it's not. No, it's not. Come on, stop. Okay. And of course, I interrupted myself. As usual. Another one of France's famous toll roads. Yeah. Go ahead and let the cruise control take care of the rest here. So next season, season 5, I probably explained this several times, but it's going to be mostly, finishing up the Vive la France DLC, and, heavy cargo pack DLC. We'll be looking into that. And, as far as anything after that, I really won't be doing a season 6, at least for this year, so, unless SCS Software announces something about a new expansion or something, but, I'm not really, looking to do any more seasons until next year, so season 5 looks like it's gonna be it for this year. I really don't know how much longer it's going to take for us to actually go through the entire DLC. Hopefully that we'll have enough content for you guys through at least the summer and the fall. So if it gets to a point where I think we're going to be running out of stuff to do here, then we're going to have to shut it down for a while until we come up with any new DLCs or any new content that, I deem worthy that I should make a video on. So that's what this playthrough is for. The playthrough's not gonna stop anytime soon, but that's why I'm starting season 5, so we can finish up the DLC and look at the heavy cargo pack DLC, which, I might do, I don't know, it just kind of just depends, really. So we're probably going to do, I don't know how long season 5 is going to be, but we're just going to have to see. Now, as for season 3, I think, of ATS, season 2 I don't think is very long. I think it's only going to be 11 episodes, but, yes. Season 3 is going to tell us actually getting everything pretty much all, everything cleaned up, all the cities we've not discovered yet. So season 3 will actually be pretty big with ATS, and that's probably going to be the last season until the New Mexico DLC is out. So yeah, once we get done with all that, then it's going to be pretty quiet on this channel for a while again. So unless I decide to start another game or something, which I really don't have any plans so right now. They're 41 euros. Alright then. Looks like there's a truck there. It's resting for a while. Alright. starting to get into rush hour now. Kind of had to focus on that while, you know, for a little while. Man, this traffic's heavy. All right. So, yeah. So, that's pretty much what my plans are for right now. So, hopefully, we won't be going through this that fast. Like, this particular week, because I'm, you know, on vacation from work. So, I'll probably be uploading quite a few videos this week. So, so this one, it's about 1 in the morning here. So, I'm probably not gonna get around to uploading this tonight, but I plan on doing this in the morning. And it's a weird spot for traffic lights. Alright. There's like nobody coming. Yeah, it's like some of the traffic lights here in Houston. It's like late at night, you stop at a red light on the access road in one of our tollways, and you can just sit there for a couple minutes, and you're like, hey, nobody's coming. Majority of the people run the lights, but, you know. Hey. Posse. that's funny. Where's my posse? Yeah, that's very corny, I know. This guy's like right beside me, so it's kind of like... a fuel stop. We're getting there, but it's not quite at half a tank yet, so I don't necessarily want to have to. So yeah, we're just gonna the hell are we anyway? This must be a really, really small town or something going through here. There's, oh no, roundabout. Just love to throw these in here on this new DLC. Yeah, well. I don't like them. I still don't. Yeah, it looks like we're going through some small villages through here. The speed limit's not really too high right now, about 31 miles an hour, so. kind of pacing myself through here. Oh, that was Posse. I see. It's one of the many things I love about France is their small roads they have here. It's I think it's pretty cool. Oh, okay. I don't know why that looked like a two-lane street there for a minute. I don't know why, but right. Finally, some very large highways. That's good to hear. So. But, yep. As you're joining us, I was kind of. Oh, this is kind of cool. Never been through a thing like this before. It's almost like a partially unfinished. I don't know why that's covered like that. It's a bit weird. Okay, then. It is three lanes. Okay. Three lanes of forward traffic. I like that. Very nice. Oh, okay. That's a bit scary going out there because I couldn't really figure out where the road was going. So let's see here. So I'm gonna be going. You know, I kind of want to be on that right side. There we go. There's this one, one large loop there. All right. So, yeah. So hopefully we won't, so luckily we don't have to go through any more toll booths, for at least for a little while. That's what mostly this route is, mostly toll roads. So. You know, I'm kind of wondering where they're actually going to go, which direction they're going to go with this game. I know for sure that they're going to be eventually going into Russia and Asia and stuff like that. But I kind of want to know if they're going to be going into Spain and Portugal. Which I could probably say is where they're going next in this game. But I'm sure a lot of their focus is on American Truck Simulator right now. So that's why I want to mostly play this game right now, is because, you know, I'm the furthest. I don't know. I wouldn't say I'm the furthest behind in this game, but well, let's just say that I got a lot of catching up to do. Let's just say that. Fixing a turn off here. Alright. So it looks like we're turning off onto a smaller road, it looks like. So yeah, like I said before, I'd like to see them going to Spain and going to Portugal and stuff like that, because, you know, that's one of the, that's pretty much the southwestern side of Europe that they have not covered yet. So it'd be really cool if they made an Australia DLC. I don't know how they would do that though, because that's clearly on the, let's say it's a few thousand miles away from Europe, but I don't know. It'd be kind of cool to see an Australian truck simulator or something. I don't know if you would call it that, but. I guess it could be in the game itself, but, well, yeah, it could be, because Australia is a very large country, so. I've always wanted to go and check out Australia. It's one of the many countries I like to visit someday. Yeah, we are getting there, surely but slowly. So we're about a half a tank on fuel again. So this is one of the main reasons why I get the Giga Space, is because it has such a larger fuel tank, and I can go a little bit further without having to worry about filling it up all the time. So I know in the past when we try to drive the Kamaz 6460, I don't know. It's just, you know, I never really got a chance to fully show off that truck, you know. It was only for a few episodes, and then something glitched out, and I couldn't use it anymore. So, back in the day when I actually had problems in this game, because I had the non-Steam version, so. Yay, it's another toll booth. Oh, I am. Why am I not so shocked? 78 euros. Good grief, France. I guess still trying to pay back the cost made to build the Statue of Liberty, huh? Yeah, that's where we got it, folks, was from France. So. Yeah, this is mostly the newer area of France. You can see that the highways are a lot more, you know, a lot wider, more open, and a lot easier and less stressful, even at 2:30 in the afternoon on a Saturday. In the game, right now it's Wednesday morning, in real time for me, so. Yeah, this is a pretty long trip, but it's not going to be as long as when, you know, when they have a lot more DLCs out for American Truck Simulator. Try going all the way from the West Coast to the East Coast. That's going to be years away, you know. Probably in season 15 or 16 of this playthrough. So, yeah. This playthrough will not be done until they've covered all 50 states. And Canada, if they decide to do so. Because you know Canada is probably going to be included way, way, way many years in the future. So, just count on it. Even though it's an American Truck Simulator, it is Canada's in North America. I don't know if they're going to include Mexico or not, but. Yeah, we'll see. I don't know. That's a good question. I'll tell you what, though. The games have been coming out recently for, like, console games and stuff. I've been fairly disappointed with, you know? I mean, I know they got that game, that Prey, which is actually kind of a reboot of the series. You know, they wanted to go a different direction with it. Instead, the first Prey, I thought, was a pretty good game. But, this one was more, I don't know, I seriously like the whole aliens abduct this Native American and Native American kicks ass, you know, I think it was a really cool idea for it. A lot of people thought that the game was too easy, but, well, I tend to like AC games. You know, they're, you know, I think they're more fun, you know, for me at least. A lot of people like more difficult games, you know. And of course, there's Doom out there. Doom is an amazing game. I am just not good at first-person shooters, so I don't even bother with that game. But it looks fun, though. I'm just mainly more of a simulation game type person, so. But there is this new simulation game that looks pretty cool, though. It's, do not turn in front of me. Alright, there. That's a good truck. It's called On the Road, I think. I saw something unlocked this on YouTube, and, well, the promo for it was in German, so I really could not understand what it was saying about it, but I got kind of a basic idea. So they got a huge, they got a few cities there in Germany. They're like full, you know, full scale size cities, and you get to drive this delivery truck around there. So I don't know if it's just that one delivery truck, or they're gonna add stuff later. I don't know, but I was like, that's gonna look pretty cool. I don't know, maybe they can translate that to English, and that'd be great, you know. Because, you know, so I've tried, Amici 2, which is it's a German, bus simulator is what it is. It's pretty in-depth, you know. So it's sort of like Train Simulator in a way, where you kind of have to have owner's manual to kind of understand what to do, and you gotta be able to translate German too, because they don't have, because I know they made some that were like in Chicago and stuff like that are actually in English, but the base game itself is in Germany, so a lot of stuff is in German, and we just don't understand that. They don't have an English translation for it, so it's kind of hard, you know, because I played around with it, and my system, it handles it, okay. Because my system's really not the best, but that's why I had to play on medium resolution all the time. But yeah, it's just a pretty fun game if you know how to play it. It's kind of a complex one. But, you know, once you actually learn to actually, you know, use it properly, it's a pretty fun game, you know. But as for any simulation game, it's not for everybody. There's also this other game, which is completely off subject, but it's called House Flipper. I thought this was quite funny, but you see all those shows on TV, you know. If any of you people out there like watch HGTV or Do It Yourself Network and stuff, that there's all those house flipping shows. Well, they've actually created a game where you actually do that. It's kind of a simulation. So I don't know if the promos, it actually looked quite interesting. I don't know how in depth the game goes, really, but I'd be kind of anxious to see how that works, you know. Don't really know. Ugh. It is rainy as ever. So it looks like we're just about there. It's only about 25 miles to our destination, so yeah, we Bates making some pretty good time here. This rain is nasty. Hope this rain will let up before it gets dark, because I hate driving at night when it's raining. I don't think anybody really does. Especially where I live, because the drivers suck. Yeah, this weather is bad. All right. Yeah, we're definitely going to be needing some more fuel once we deliver this cargo, but we'll just have to worry about that for next time. Because next video, we're going to be looking into the heavy cargo DLC. So, can't wait for that. I want to see what they've actually done to it. And see how long it's going to take us to haul a heavy cargo, because it's not smooth sailing like it is right now. I mean, it's actually going to be take a lot longer than usual, so. This weather is bad. Holy crap. I think it's starting to let up a little bit now. Okay, the rain finally stopped. Which is good, because we're about 45 miles away from our destination. You know what? I noticed something that there really isn't very many fuel stops on this road. Now that I think about it, I've not seen one in a long time. Whoa, that glare is bad. Oh. That was close. Yeah, like I said, I'm bad at those intersections. I'm always in the wrong lane. Right. All lands going towards Toulouse. That's where I want to go. Oh, it's another toll booth. Why am I not shocked? Toll booth after freaking toll booth. Wow, it's like, you know what? This is a lot like, it's a lot like Houston in a way. Yeah. Oh, this is interesting. Exit right off the... Interesting. Okay. This is a... I never seen that before. You know, actually, there's a entrance... There's like a exit right past... Right by the toll booth there. That's... Bon Voyage! 1623. All right. So that means we have about, what, 7 more cities to discover? So. All right. scared the crap out of me. I thought I, I ran into somebody. This is interesting. Well, this is an interesting way to get into this place. That is not straight at all. Oh well, we'll take it though. I thought that was straight. Nice. Woo! Oh man, that was an exhausting trip. Alright. It's gonna be. Been to Paris? Yeah, we have. Been to La Mer. Been to Burgess? Yes. Been to La Mer. Oh, well, crap. Now, might have to take a few small, short trips until we find something we want. But, alright, well, in the meantime, folks, well, that's going to be it for the season finale of Season 4 of ETS2. I hope everybody has enjoyed this this season, and in there as short as it was. And how long delayed it was. Hopefully next season that won't be the case. But so next season, look forward to more Viva La France DLC along with the Heavy Cargo Pack DLC. And we will go from there. So this is Rest 2484 signing off. See you next time.